Variables are used for storing data during program execution. Depending on what data we need to store, there are several different kinds of data types. In C++, the exact size and range of the data types aren't fixed. Instead, they are dependent on the system we compile for. The sizes shown in this table are those found on most 32-bit systems. By default, a char in C++ is 1 byte in size. A byte here is the minimum addressable unit of memory, which is guaranteed to be at least 8 bits, but might also be 16 or 32 bits depending on the system. The general specification is that the int type will have the same size as the system word. So for a 32-bit system, where the smallest addressable unit is 8 bits, the integers will be 4 bytes long. Each integer type in this table must also be at least as large as the one preceding it. The same applies to the floating point types, where each one must provide at least as much precision as the preceding one. To create a variable, we start with the data type we want it to hold, followed by an identifier, which is the name of the variable. In general, the name can consist of letters, numbers, and underscores, but it cannot start with a number. Also, it cannot contain spaces or special characters, and it mustn't be a reserved keyword. We assign a value to the variable using the equal sign, which is the assignment operator. We can also combine the declaration and assignment into a single statement. At the same time that the variable is declared, we have an alternative way of initializing it by enclosing the value in parentheses. This is known as constructor initialization and is equivalent to the first method. If we need to declare more than one variable of the same type, there's a shorthand way to do this using the comma operator. As we see here, integers can also be assigned using octal and hexadecimal notation as well as standard decimal. All numbers here represents the same number, which in decimal notation is 50. Once we have a variable declared and initialized, we can then use it by simply referencing the variable's name. An important thing to keep in mind is that variables in C# are not initialized to zero by default. Instead, they will contain whatever garbage is left in that memory location. It's therefore a good idea to always give your variables an initial value.